Y hay chocolate.
God has a funny way of showing you lessons. For years I would stare up in the sky with so many questions. Like, will I find someone for me? Or even if I'm standing in a place I need to be. I can't say that every love affair I had was perfect, but every painful day and late night was worth it. Now I realize everyone that laid me down led me to you. Oh, babe.
Yes, your wonderful, sweet, solid and stamina princess Silke. Hola, ¿qué tal? And what? Yeah, let me say it real quick and fast and straightforward. Salieri, my ass. I thought betrayal, that fits the bill of Salieri very well. Betrayal, yeah, to whom he admired, doubtfully. You know what the issue is with Salieri? Salieri could see Mozart. He understood what Mozart was all about. So no, it didn't fit him. He can't understand what I do. He doesn't see it. Did me said it again and again and again. He doesn't distinguish kitchen style. Excuse me. He has no interest. On and on. I'm tired. Did you listen to your lesson? There was no lesson. Not for you, boys and girls. Nee. And yeah, lame doesn't understand. Why is the rhythmical machine, yeah, who imitates the drums and stuff, why does the buttons don't amount to 16? 4 on each side. Yeah, but I never had one of those. It's just simple deduction. Logic? Maybe. Really? I feel like I'm living in a parallel universe. I have to explain that. But just deduct it. Just logic it into the system. Well, that requires a little bit of intelligence, maybe. To take a few values and put them together in a new light. You have to remember this is about attention. Accessing the field is about addressing an attention. I do not particularly care for palindromes. On the other hand, when I speak, I incite you to look. And whenever I do something, I reinforce it. And see, this hurts me doing this because I'm not the kind of lame, stupid asshole teacher. Anybody else but might trigger himself too. Because I don't give you out shit. In particular, this is not about learning vocabulary. No, I'm not going to leave you alone. This is not about you learning now. See, for the asshole shit, it's going to give you a bunch of big fat words so you feel like an idiot. That's precisely not what I want to do. It defeats the purpose of my insertion in your life. Because words don't matter. I can tell you Anna or Otto. And then I can say, oh, look what happens. And I can tell you it's called, I just named the name. Because I do expect you to understand what I say. And I'm gonna get back on you or with you. And I do not expect you to guess when I told you yesterday what the word is in what Greek? I do not expect you to know. If you have interest, go for it. If you don't, then don't do it. It doesn't matter. Hence my simple language, which is not that simple, by the way. For many, it is not at all. Yeah, particularly of the very large and huge construction of my sentences. Yeah, look closely. They are so composed and they're full of logic, sensitivity, sincerity, honesty, and furthermore, love. For you to feel great to hang out with someone who is grandiose but doesn't like to say it. Yeah, man, you my people if you wish to, if you choose to. And echar palabrotas in English. It's not gromo. What's gromo? Oh, largo. What's largo? Oh, calo. No, okay, I repeat those. You get a little notion. Maybe say big words which no one understands, or maybe yes, but then again no, it doesn't matter. Because it does matter if I will use them, because then I expect you to learn them. And that's not what I want. I mean, like I said, now I'm being repetitive. See, that's not what I usually do. I want you to look, have interest, access the field. That's all what you have to do. With these many stories, you might achieve to get insights, probably and hopefully feel better about yourself, know where you're at. I like the word oxymoron because it's kind of it's almost an albur. Yeah, because ox, you know what that is. Instead for stupid, I can tell you the word, or I can ask you to, but this is the kind of thing I do not do. Now, I produced so many videos yesterday. I just, right now, which is, yeah, not even noon, but just about to finish listening to. That was a composed sentence, just a double or triple. I make them longer sometimes. There are so very many ways I talk to you. I do not wish you to go, now go rewind and find the word. This is not what I need. But I feel uncomfortable if I leave things pending. I feel uncomfortable when I leave things up there. So I would not have used the word. I was invited to give you the speech. Just to assure you that my aim is for you to understand and to glorify, yeah, maybe God, when you find stuff within yourself. When I see usage for certain things, I say it. I think I can find usage for the word oxymoron. And you know how often I look them up sometimes, because I have such, yeah, requested attention, so you feel okay. Look them up again. What does it mean? Look them up again. One can get confused with those things, especially when you're not with people who you actually use these words with. Why would you? But is it this or the other one? It's okay, look it up again. Well, it's not neither one's language, people. You are not born with those words, and they are not given to you in any kind of school. You learn them much later, if at all, you go study. If at all, maybe perhaps, that type of study includes these words, which has to be a social study. And if you would like to become a student of many words, that's wonderful. And if you don't, that's just wonderful. So usually when I use words, I also explain immediately what they mean.
Don't be mad, don't get me.
Don't be mean.
Hey, don't be mad, don't get me.
Don't get mad, don't be mean.
Wait, I don't mean no harm. I can see you with my t-shirt on.
I can see you with nothing on. Feeling on me before you bring that on. Only trying to get inside of your brain to see if you can work me the way you say.
It's okay, it's alright. I got something that you don't like.
Mm-hmm.